Oh, Heavenly Father, I thank you, Lord, for these words on top this wall, Lord, amazing grace. For your grace, Lord, that we don't deserve, but you give it to us so that we can live and we live because of it, Lord. So Jesus, we thank you for what you've done for us, the things that you continue to do, Lord. I thank you for everybody here. As we hear, Lord, let your spirit guide us in truth and into your presence, Lord. And worship you, Lord, for you are worthy. So Lord, we give you this night, we give you all the praises, all the glory. In Jesus' name. Things, he says. Our love never fails. Love believes all things. You know, when I heard that, believes all things, how can something believe all things? Yeah? But God's grace, God, He believes in us. love. He believed in all things because he made all things with no purpose. Yeah? That's why his grace, Jesus, whoo, on. So Lord, we thank you, Lord, for your love, your grace, your unfailing.
Oh,
To you, Lord, I just pray that, that your word Let your truth, let your spirit just pull, Lord, do your thing. We praise you, Jesus. We thank you for what's been done for us. The glory of your goodness, Father, is in Jesus. Lord, you are the glory. It's crazy that you allow us to enter into that glory, Lord. We can become part of that glory. Not our glory, but from glory to glory. We can please you, Lord. We can honor you with this life that we've been given. So yes, Lord, let us be with our will and our, yeah, Lord. Let us acknowledge and recognize who you are tonight, Lord, right now. So we can get free. Woo. In Jesus' name. Amen.
All right, so just a few announcements. Somebody get that kid under control. Whose kid is that? Kachi. Okay, yes. So just a few announcements. Pastor Ryan and myself will not be on island for the next 2 weeks. But Sunday evening service will still be going on. So we will be having with us, of course, we have Pastor Jamie, who's back there. Pastor Jamie just came end of June, I believe. End of June, yeah? He moved over?
Yeah.
Yeah. End of June. So she's here, part of the pastoral staff with Molokai Naz. And her husband, Pastor Hauoli, is also going to be joining us. But he will be here for the next 2 Sundays. Yay. Yeah? Yay! Pastor Hauoli. So Pastors Jamie and Hauoli will be leading worship, I believe, and sharing the word, and we'll still have the dinner and everything that's happening with Sunday night service. So these next 2 weeks, there will be no youth group. So Kalamai Youth, no youth group these next 2 Fridays. We would normally have young adult ministry this Wednesday. We will not be having young adult ministry this Wednesday, though. And we will not be having any Thursday night co-ed Bible study until September. Something to look at in your bulletins, though, is while we are gone, that's a third Thursday. So we are in a lot of need of help. We need helping hands or people that are willing to bring breakfast items in the morning time or that can help with lunch for those who are helping with our food bank ministry. What that is we are going to meet up here at the church at 8:00 in the morning, eat breakfast, and then head down to Veterans Center and assist Salvation Army with their process of getting Maui Food Bank items to the agencies and ministries on the island. So please help. If you have not helped yet, this is a good time to start. But we are in need of some helping hands. And I think that's all of the announcements. Yeah? Yeah, that's all of them.
I think it's on air when you rush up, yeah? You know, we worship, we get to kind of remind ourselves about who God is. Like the words that we're choosing for worshiping with, like we're asking the Holy Spirit to come and change us. Yeah? I mean, let us be aware. Your presence is welcome here, Lord. Like, whew, we're talking to our inner man too at the same time. And like, we're praising God, but we're getting our hearts ready. Yeah? We turn into the Lord once again. Yeah? And that's what I'm. That's what communion is about, yeah? Like, tonight we're going to take communion, and I believe the Lord, he set them up like this. I mean, the Lord, he was always reminding, that, you know, like the Old Testament, all the laws and all the things that they had to follow, all the festivals, Passover, the feast, all these things to observe was to remind them, man, to remind them about their slavery in Egypt, for remind them about the Passover, for remind them all the things, yeah? So I believe like Jesus, Jesus, he told the disciples, eh? Before he was going to the cross, his life we get, he said, I gotta go, boys. So that the Holy Spirit, he will come and he will remind you what I'm telling you. Yeah? He will set your mind back to me. Yeah, back to, because me, Jesus said, like, me, I only do what I see the Father do. I show you how the Father operates. Well, I saw in you who your Father is, yeah? And he like give you all this, but he will give you his spirit so that you can live. But that's what I believe, Jesus, that's what, as part of, like, we get communion, eh? He wanted to make sure, not make sure, but give us some reference, right? Like, we get to come back to him, but we get to once again gather in his name. And but it doesn't even say do it once a month. Like Jesus says, much as times as you guys come together and you acknowledge what I will do and who I am, this life is in you. Yeah? You're practicing this for your own souls and your own spirit, yeah? So you can kind of like, wow, thank you, Lord, come back. Because the word communion, union, yeah? Commune, community, it means for come together. Back to come is one, man. You know? So we come back to Rakhine. We come back. And that's what we're doing every Sunday. Every time we gather, we come back to Rakhine. Oh, Lord, thank you. You know? I don't know about you guys, but like when I stay on Bible study, or I can feel the presence, I can feel the Lord, I can hear him, I can see him in my spirit and my Rakhine. I feel like, oh, that oneness, that honor come back, yeah? You know? So tonight we're going to be in Matthew 14. Verse 13 through 21. And this one famous one that, you know, most everybody know about Jesus feeding the 5,000, yeah? So at this time, Jesus had plenty of people following him, man. He was doing, you know, he was healing, he was casting out evil spirits, he was proclaiming the kingdom. People was just following him. Even to the point where they never eat for 3 days. They just keep following Jesus. Eh? That's our honor loss. Like. But, so, we'll read them. Jesus feeds 5,000. 13. As soon as Jesus heard the news, he left the... Okay. The news that Jesus heard right before this, he heard that his cousin John the Baptist didn't pass away. Or he got beheaded. He got news that his cousin was in jail. John the Baptist, yeah. Oh, Matthew 14. We're going to start verse 13, but where the thing will start, I want to let you guys know what news he heard. He even heard his cousin John the Baptist went pass away or got beheaded. So 13, as soon as Jesus heard the news, he left in a boat to a remote area to be alone. But the crowds heard where he was headed and followed on foot from many towns. Jesus saw the huge crowds as he stepped from the boat, and he had compassion on them, and he healed their sick. That evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a remote place, and it's already getting late. Send the crowds away so they can go to the villages and buy food for themselves." But Jesus said, "That isn't necessary. You feed them." "But we only have 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish, they answered. "Bring them here," he said. Then he told the people to sit down on the grass. Jesus took the 5 loaves and 2 fish and looked up towards heaven and blessed them. Then breaking the loaves into pieces, he gave the bread to the disciples who distributed it to the people. They all ate as much as they wanted, and afterwards, the disciples picked up 12 baskets of leftovers, and about 5,000 men were fed that day, in addition to all the women and children. Who? So 5,000, they only called men, eh? But they had women and children, so took a 5,000, yeah? He'd feed the masses. But this is like one place where Jesus, you know, plenty of times when Jesus is talking to his disciples, they cannot really see what he really saying. Like the counter, the deeper the kind behind him, man. Us, we blessed, we say 2,000 years ahead, we get to read all the stories, and we get to like, we can discern and we can connect all Jesus' words and the way everything connected. But I like this, you know, though Jesus was fully God, he was fully man. Yeah, so in this verse, you can see he's human. He heard his cousin was dead. But he said, "But I gotta go to a remote place by myself, man." You know? But Jesus, he was so, right now, his ministry was pumping so much that people wouldn't let him be alone, man, like too long. I mean, they're following him, man. They're yearning for him. But he looked at them and he said, like, he felt compassion on them, man, because they, what is it? It's getting late, or because this will not get any food for themselves. Compassion, oh, he stepped from the boat and he had compassion on them and healed their sick. So, I mean, when he came up on the boat, everybody was coming up and he felt that compassion, eh? And he just started healing them. Eh? But then his disciples remind him that this is a remote place and it's getting late. Eh? So his disciples might have been hungry too, eh? But they noticed that yeah, he planted people. And he tell the, his disciples tell Jesus, tell the people for go home and eat. Go and eat something. And Jesus look at them. You feel. Yeah? That's not necessary. You feel. And they're like, oh Jesus, we only get two breads. Or five breads and two fish. Yeah. And we all heard this story already. And it's like with God, anything is possible, yeah. Amen. And that's what he's showing there, man. I mean, Jesus, he did this two times, yeah. He would feed 4,000 guys one time, and he'd feed this 5,000. And then even afterwards, they was going someplace on a boat, and his disciples was talking like they was worried that they never had bread. They forgot to bring the bread. We forgot to bring the food. And Jesus said, look at us. You guys still not understand who you eat. I would feed like 9,000 people, and he's still wondering about who am I? I'm the bread. He said, no, let the yeast of the Pharisees, no, let the yeast of unbelief come among you guys, bro. Like, hey, believe. I stay with you. You know, no worry. Yeah? And time after time, but just like us, yeah? You know, God always reminded us how much miracles he did in our life. Yeah? You know, but sometimes we got to think and we got to turn, eh? We got to repent. We got to turn back and remind. The Lord remind us, or we remind ourselves how good God is, yeah? And like we like hope. Okay. Okay. But in this one, I mean like we heard these ones already, but in this one, you know, me and Mahana was talking, eh? And we seen a different kind of style. Like tonight we're gonna be partaking in the communion, right? And when Jesus sat down with his disciples, he broke the bread. He said, I break this bread, and this is my body, which is broken for you. Yeah? Then he gave him the blood, which is the kind. This is for your sins. This is for your body. And he, in here, it says that all the people was hungry. Yeah? The opus was hungry. The physical was hungry. Yeah? But see, Jesus took the little that had and said, he would bless them. He would sanctify him for a purpose. Yeah? He would look up to heaven and he broke. He said he would bless him and he broke him. Yeah? Same picture like his body. Yeah? But Jesus, he don't feed the people. He give the bread to his disciples. He said, here, you guys go give them out. And let them eat as much as they like until they're full. Until even had leftovers. Yeah? And that just give me one picture of like this gospel that we get, his word, eh? This good news. Jesus' body been broken for us. Yeah? And then, because come on time in our life when we receive him, yeah? And we receive him, we tell thank you. God, thank you. And but that should change your life, eh? To where when you follow in Jesus, he won't give you the honor for give everybody. It's not even for you, like. Yeah, afterwards, you become a servant, eh? So, just like the bread that was blessed, God bless you, eh? And me. Like, he sanctify us, eh? What that means, when you say that you bless, yeah? Or you sanctify, yeah? It's mean that you set apart for a purpose, yeah? The Bible says to be holy for your Father in heaven is holy, yeah? Holy doesn't mean perfect, without blemish. Holy means your attitude towards people. Holy means the way that you separate it for a purpose. Yeah? And that purpose is you for bless other people with that bread. Yeah? You know, and that bread is Jesus. Yeah? And we set apart. We set apart for service. We servants of this gospel. Yeah? And But first, you need to, you got to receive that bread and you got to eat them. And then he said, fill up, he said, eat as much as you like. Yeah. You know, before this, I used to chase all kind of highs, all kind of drugs I do. And always chasing that kind of high. Never enough. Always got to get some more. But Jesus, he tell you, grab as much as you like. And I never felt this high before in my life. And the kind of high, you don't need to calm down. If you like some more, you grab some more. You come low, you turn, you go back high, you go that kind. Yeah? That's why I see that overflow, like eat as much as you like. Eat that kind. But, yeah, church, this is the message tonight. It's what's been given to for us, yeah? Jesus, all these symbolisms, yeah, is for the cross, yeah? It's for what would be, what would happen for us one day. But God, he changing our hearts so that we be sanctified for a purpose too, yeah? Like, you know, it's weird, bro, because in the kingdom, in the worldly mind, when you say that, when Jesus said that you gotta carry your cross, or those who lose their life will find them. The thing sounds crazy, yeah? Because you think of Jesus, he was innocent. He was without blameless, and he chose for later on his life, but for all of us. Yeah, it sounds crazy, that guy, but your freedom, bro. When you lay down your, when you're not so worried or consumed about your own self and about what you're gonna do and what this and that and that kind of, like, you get one freedom of. When you give up your life, when you lay down your life, you find them in Christ. You get a purpose. Yeah? But that kind of easy for me. Easy for talk. I mean, you can hear the words. But this is something that got to be lived out there. You got to experience it, bro. Because we forgetful people, bro. We forgetful beings. We always need that reminder. That reminder. That's why the word of God. Though all the circumstances inside this world, with humans like that, get all kind of things happen, but God, he don't change. His style is the same. He always look out for the orphans and the widows and the injustice. Amen. He always look for the kind, the unbalanced. Eh? That's why Jesus, when look at the people, he felt compassion. He said, no, you feel them. No, they deserve to eat. They're hungry. They're the kind. You my disciples. Yeah, we will feed them. They're like, oh, how are we gonna feed them? Give them to me. Wow. We bless them. We feed them. Yeah? And that's the life we get now in Christ, bro. Yeah, we get to partake in this God's plan for reconciliate, bro. Bring back everything back to him. Come back. Yeah? That's why though I know that go get on time where Jesus is gonna come back in the sky and this and that and that kind of like for. But he says that nobody know when the master gonna return. Jesus' parables, he said when he come back, he like see his servants, his people doing what he left them for do. Malama, steward, the kind, and then I'm gonna be honored. So that we live our life like you never know when he will come back. You live today, salvation. You make right today with God. If today your heart is not soft, no heart in your heart, listen to what the Spirit is saying and understand. Eh? And today, my brothers and sisters, we give an opportunity to recognize Jesus again. I mean, for who he is and what he's done for us. Eh? So I'll come on here, and we're going to talk about communion, and we're going to come together again. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Okay, yeah. Thank you, love. So tonight is a time that we are partaking in the Lord's Supper. We're going to be partaking in Holy Communion. Usually when we partake in communion, we have an idea of what that's going to look like. We know that there's going to be two people holding elements, or the elements are going to be sitting on a table, or we got a little COVID-friendly, you know, thing of communion with the Jews and the cracker on top, a little stale cracker. Like, we have an idea of what communion should look like, because we're used to taking communion in a certain way. Yeah. The same thing goes for the way that we live our lives as followers of Christ. We may think that we know what a Christian looks like because we've seen them around us. You know, we have examples of them among us. But what Jesus is calling us to is not to be a cookie cutter of anybody else. It's not to live in a culture of Christianity. It's not to be some perfectly packaged person that everybody can look at and tell they're a Christian because of what music they listen to, or what clothes they wear or don't wear, or the words they say or don't say. But it's the way that we are to each other. It's the way that we are able to feed another person the gospel. It's the way that we're able to feed another person the things that they need, because we know their needs because we know them. We're called to be connected. We're called into community. And so tonight when we partake in the Lord's Supper, church, it is not going to look like every other time that we partake in the Lord's Supper. We're going to have an opportunity to feed our neighbor, to offer the elements to our neighbor, to let them know that this bread that you just partook of yourself is bread that is also offered to them. That this juice that you dipped your bread in is the blood of Christ that was poured out for you just as much as it was poured out for them. Yeah. And I pray that this new way that we do communion tonight doesn't mean that this is what it's always going to be, because then it's easy for that to become another culture in itself. Yeah. But this is something that can be alive in us, so that when we leave these walls, when we leave this place, we're reminded of who we're called to be. People that feed, people that connect, people that see, and people that respond. Amen. So we're going to, we're going to read the passage, yeah, about the Lord's Supper in 1 Corinthians. And then usually what we do is there's music being played and everything is so nice, and we take time to reflect, you know. But like I said, we're going to do things a little bit different. There's not going to be music playing in the background. There's not going to be anybody singing. We're going to read this passage, and we're going to sit with it for a little bit. And then after that, Pastor Ryan and myself will administer communion to each other. And then I invite you to come up when you are ready to do the same. Yeah. All right, so 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23 says, "For I pass on to you what I received from the Lord himself. On the night when he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took some bread and gave thanks to God for it. Then he broke it into pieces and said, 'This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, he took the cup of wine after supper, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant between God and his people, an agreement confirmed with my blood. Do this to remember me as often as you drink it. For every time you eat this bread and drink this cup, you are announcing the Lord's death until he comes again.'" Heavenly Father, we love you so much. We thank you for this gift of life that you've given us, Lord. We thank you for this way of living that you have showed us, that is evident in you, Lord. We thank you for this way to remember all that you have done, Lord. We thank you for this holy communion where we are reminded of your body being broken for us, Lord. Of your body broken for each and every person in this world, Lord. Even before we were aware of you, Lord, you loved us. Even before we knew who you were calling our name. Lord, I thank you for this bread that is a reminder of your body that was broken for us. Lord, we also thank you for this cup of grape juice, Lord, that just signifies your blood that was poured out for us, that was not spilled out on accident, that was not haphazardly spilled on the ground, Lord, but was poured out intently for us. Lord, I thank you for this practice. Lord, I thank you for this means of grace that is Holy Communion, that reminds us of what we are called to live. Lord, I pray that when we partake in this communion, Lord, we are reminded of your sacrifice, Lord, that it was not a sacrifice to exact religious power over anybody, Lord, but it was a sacrifice of love and a sacrifice that shows us how to best love our neighbor, which is to feed them, Lord. And so we love you, Lord. We pray over each and every heart that is here tonight. We examine our hearts fully, and we come prepared to be a part of this ministry of your life, Lord, of your ministry. So we love you, we praise you, we pray this in your name, Jesus. Amen.
Ah, Heavenly Father, Abba, Father Jesus, thank you. Thank you for this life that we have in you. Thank you for what's been done for us, Lord. The reason why we can live, the reason why we have this eternal life. Thank you for thank you for this life. I just pray as we are, yeah, Lord, as we go in our life, I just pray that your spirit guide us. Help us to reveal more of you, Lord, to us, so that we can understand more and our feet can strengthen and Lord, we can experience you, Lord. And we can give you glory by the way that we treat our neighbors, those that you have us around, our family, our everyone, all the relationships. Help us to relate to them so that we can, as we relate to you, we relate to them, they can see you, Lord, and they can feel you, and they can feel that love, Lord, that comes from you, that is one. So, Lord, we give you all the glory, all the praise, all the honor. In Jesus' name. You see?
Amen.
Thank you.
Lord, that it's our desire, Lord. And if we cannot see, Lord, I just pray that you help us understand, Lord. See, change our heart, Lord. Help us to love that Holy Spirit. I just pray. I mean, you're already doing it, Lord. But I just pray for that you continue to love and minister to our hearts and help us to see more clearly, Lord. So we can discern and we can experience and give you all the glory. So, Lord, we love you. We praise you. Lord, I pray for everyone in here tonight. You know the things on our hearts and our minds that need healing, that need understanding, that need discernment. So I just pray, Lord, that you give them to us. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Hallelujah.